mushrooms in Lower Bellabertakovich. Have you ever seen such a place?
Pavel Bartokovich.
Rebecca, we have a stranger.
The first in 20 years. So send him the postcards.
Okay. We send him the postcards, but we tell him nothing.
Especially about Clinton, you know.
Alfred, at your side, Professor.
Alfred the Journal, if you please.
October 29th, 1880-something.
Yes.
We have arrived in a village that smells like feet.
Feet? Or garlic?
The intrepid professor continues his noble quest for a vampire.
Thank you, Alfred, I can do.
At your service, gentlemen. Chagal, Transylvanian innkeeper, and Rebecca, my Transylvanian wife.
Abronsius, international vampiricist. And Alfred, my faithful factotum.
His factotum?
It means that I think it does, they can't leave right now.
Mr. Chagall, is there perchance a castle nearby?
Castle?
Perchance the castle von Krolock. Stop that!
Excuse me! Sir, not the castle von Krolock. You go across the street to take a left.
Boris!
Sir, you sitting?
Go push the garments. Rebecca, get the gentleman's bags.
Not the bags.
Boris?
Just trying to be helpful.
Sunset! Sunset! Get to your homes! Lock your doors! Fall your shutters! Save yourselves, for God's sake!
Your village seems to fear sunset.
No! It's the wolves, sir.
Oh,
they can be real devils.
Devils, eh? Legend has it, the devil can't come in unless he's invited in.
Come in.
Good evening, Mr. Chagall.
Madame McCrook.
You have any blood red silk suitable for a ball gown, Mr. Chagall?
Of course, Countess. A pack of silk.
Magda silk.
Yeah, yeah.
And how is your daughter, Mr. Chagall? The fair Sarah.
My Sarah, my prize, my jewel.
She has a birthday suit, does she not?
Yes, madame, in 2 nights.
And the total eclipse of the moon?
On Halloween.
It's too good.
But she's ailing, madame. She's feverish.
She's been acting so strangely today.
Oh, may I go up and visit the poor girl?
No, madam, you may not. No one may. It is Abronsius of Heidelberg who speaks.
Ooh. I'm scared. Mrs. Jed, are you still having those nightmares? Congratulations. A good nightmare comes soon, then.
The silk, madame.
Excellent. You can see your hand run through it. Made by the nuns in France, you know. I hate nuns.
Yes, madame. Who doesn't?
Put it on my tab. Tell your daughter to mind herself, Mr. Chagall. The wolves, you know, they have a heartless appetite. But then, don't we all?
She's looking well.
Mr. Chagall, I have arrived just in time. For I can save your village and your daughter.
My Sarah, my prize, my
jewel. I have traveled the world and rid it of vampires. That's right, vampires. Now there's only one of those monsters left in the entire world. And I will have him, the Count Giovanni von Krolock.
Sir, there's more than one. You know, there's a whole pack.
Please, madam, don't interrupt me, for where there is smoke, I know there's a campfire, and where there's a fear of sunset, I know there's a...
vampire.
You think I haven't got a clue? Your cringing makes me weary. It's time I introduce to you my fundamental theory. Logic, logic, the world is based on logic. When I was but a little totter sitting on my mama's knee, a visionary thought I got as clue as trigonometry. It's logic.
Logic.
The answer is logic. So to Heidelberg I traveled at the tender age of 7. All my courses I unraveled by the time I turned 11 using logic.
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 I became pedagogic. My reason's clear, my thinking's fervid. Asians won't elude me. This early bird will get his worm. Simply can't elude me. Put me to the test and you will find that this professor's mine. With a logic unmistakable, irrational reality, your stubbornness I'll shake and break your confidentiality. My skill is unsurpassable, my thinking truly awesome, yet I do become irascible with people playing possum like you do. I've been seeking out my neck with such impeccable detection while deflecting all the dread which you inflict in my direction. I came all the way from Heidelberg to undertake my final quest to save your suicidal blood up to my level headed as with you. You may be a simple pigeon, but you find I can toboggan if you won't be had a smidgen of the knowledge in my noggin. I'll induce yourself as pretty while I execute the high kick and use the interfering, the logical or psychic at my kick. To detect the undetectable is what you had expected me dissecting the respectable, just like an epidemic in my brain. It's like a razor cutting wing in the confusion of being hidden from the haze of my feeling being more illusion. This is true.
What was that?
Boris, why don't you leave those fucking
master.
Yeah. I'm watching a tender freaking Eisenberg and bring out his ass.
Could you speak that by me again?
I'm going to need these bags.
Yes, master.
There's a lifetime of research in there.
Indeed, master.
You're a good man. But try to be a little less strange. Sprinkle
and drape this orange and black flake paper around them. Mr. Chagal.
Sir.
You set up this pumpkin.
This will really scare them away.
Boris.
Yes, master.
In this bag are 10 silver nails. Keep them very close.
I'll obey, master.
There's still something strange about that man.
Merciful gods. How could you let this angel be tainted?
Fear not, my boy. It's all passing from her memory. See, the punctures are disappearing from her neck, even as you bleed.
A girl as beautiful as she, I have never seen. A girl as beautiful as she, so disarming, I have never seen. There's never been a night like this since my life began. The things I do for just one kiss, I might never understand. I'm too excited, I can't sleep, I'm awake, yet I dream. My heart's ignited with a deep burning ache, and I dream another dream.
I wish I had a night like this. Makes me sad, oh Magda. A maid as beautiful as she, I have never, ever had. I got a pumpkin.
flying bloodsucker is so close I can feel his breath. The moment this girl is by herself, he'll be on her like a metaphor. So, don't leave her alone for a second.
Well, I won't.
Guard her with your life.
I will.
I'll be in the toilet.
Remember? Sarah. Such a beautiful name.
Who are you?
I'm Alfred, a former theology student turned factotum. And thanks to an apparatus, my blood is part of your blood now.
So we have had a mystical marriage.
Yes.
A union of our separate essences.
You and I are one, if still legally two.
But why are you here?
I am on a mission to rid the world of a monster. For there is an evil after you, Sarah.
Not the...
Yes, the...
And you're not afraid?
I don't fear the undead. I fear the unliving, craven souls afraid to experience life.
I said exactly the same thing. Do you keep a journal?
Here it is.
Here's mine.
You're on page 342.
You're not in mine. Not yet. But you will be the moment I find the words to do you justice.
Sarah, leave this horror. Hie home with me to Heidelberg.
My father! Please! It's good enough for me. Sleep now, my Sarah. And may all your dreams be golden. When a man has got a pretty daughter, then his life is pretty filled with pain. She never does the things he taught her. It's enough to drive a man insane. It's a pity that I must conceal you, though you're lovely as a budding rose. But there's always someone out to steal you. You can't see them, but your father knows. Sleep, my little darling. Tender starling, no one must take me, no one must take you. You're not ready, I'm not ready, we're not ready to leave daddy. Now you're looking forward to your birthday. You still think that it is fun to grow, but to me your birthday is a cursed day. You're old enough to go. Sleep, my sweet confection. Papa's your protection. No one must confuse you. No one will abuse you. You're not ready. I'm not ready. No one's ready. Don't.
Ah!
total eclipse of La Luna?
Yes. Now I remember something.
And your birthday ball at my castle?
Castle ball?
By invitation only. So, will you come to my ball? To dance in the red velvet boots?
Red velvet boots?
Do you want to come? You're pathetic, little peasant! You think I have time for a meeting with nothing like you! I'm sorry. I have nothing but time for you. Listen, I can hear your laughing from me. It's so sluggish, like mud, like sludge. It's only 80 beats per minute. Make it run faster, Sarah. Make it match mine. Can you hear my blood? That's 180 beats per minute. Listen. Boom. You look scared.
I am scared.
We are scared. I'm scared too. It feels good, doesn't it? We travel every day in a box. You're stuck day and night in this room, in this inn. Every way out is fitted with locks. The time for the sound has arrived, and the choice must be made very soon. Take a look at the sky, there's a signal for you. Behold the bloodshot moon. If you don't believe me, ask your friends.
Thank you.
midnight tomorrow. Will you come?
Yes.
Swear to me.
I swear it.
Swear to me on your father's grave.
But my father isn't dead yet.
Let's pretend. Swear to me on your father's grave.
I swear it on my father's grave. I will come.
Until tomorrow, then. And remember, be punctual. Ciao, Bella.
Bye, Sam.
A good nightmare comes so rarely when mediocre dreams are so easy to find. A good nightmare comes so rarely.
Wasn't really a good man.
No, he wasn't a good man. But He was the only man I had.
Ah, oh, look at him. Isn't it odd?
So still. And how he used to scamper. Always scampering after dreams.
Just like us all with our dreams.
I always dreamt of having a proper kitchen. One without rats. Or smaller rats.
I always wanted a hair salon. Or a whorehouse.
Kneel to me.
bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
Bless you, child, for you have desired. So have we all.
But you see, Father, I've met this man. He's very...
charming. Cosmopolitan. Handsome.
Well, he has this amazing accent.
Accent?
I swore I'd meet him tonight. I swore it on my father's grave. And now my father has died!
Nonsense! Your father is waiting for you in the castle. At the ball.
How do you know about the ball?
Oh, this place stinks of cabbage and corruption. But you, Sarah, you smell of youth. You smell of perfume, thighs, and powdered breasts. For your penance, powder them again.
How do you know my name? Who are you, really?
I come bearing a birthday gift from your papa. Open when the moment is right.
But how will I know when that moment is?
Why not now? This moment is as ripe as you are.
Sarah, what are you doing outside? Don't you realize how dangerous this is?
I just wanted some air.
Oh, then you're either incredibly foolish or unbelievably brave.
What time is it, Alfred?
Nearly midnight?
You needn't watch over me.
Oh, I love you, Sarah.
No, Alfred, you mustn't.
And we are one blood, remember?
Yes, I feel that too. But time, Alfred, the time is ticking away.
Was braver than I am.
Thank you.
to rip down my spine. Alfred, would you get my scarf?
Okay. And then we're off.
Yes, and then we're off.
Thank you.
darkness, your salvation, curse the day.